Hi everyone, how are you doing? In last class we have discussed DC motor. The parts of the DC motor and the working of the DC motor. And in last class also I have asked the question, why we are using carbon brush, why not copper, why not aluminium? So today I am going to discuss this. Why only carbon brush is used in motors. Okay, so let us start. First point, the melting point of the carbon is high in comparison to your copper or aluminium. Melting point of carbon is greater than your melting point of copper. Then how it is going to help? Why this point we are mentioning? Actually, the brushes, as you know, the brushes are connected to commutator. Actually, DC motor is having two parts, rotator and stator. Stator means the parts that are not moving, like wear, battery, your magnet, they are not moving. But the armature, the commutator, they are moving. They are the rotating part of your motor. So brush, what this brush is doing, carbon brush is doing, that is connecting your external circuit, that is your wear and battery, to your internal circuit through commutator. So brushes are connected to commutator. So when the commutator will start rotating, then what will happen? Spark will produce. So there will be spark because this is your commutator. Okay? And brush is connected over here. So when this will rotate, what will happen? So with like this brush and the commutator, there will be this friction sort of thing. So when the commutator will rotate, it will create spark. If spark is produced, that means some heat is also produced. So if heat is produced, then what it will do? It will melt. It will melt. Since carbon brush is having high melting point, with that heat also it will not melt. So current flow will continue and our motor function will have no impact because of the melting point of carbon brush. Is it clear, children? Since carbon brush melting point is very high, when the commutator rotates, there will be spark. Because of that, heat will produce. And after the heat generation, it should melt. Since it has a high melting point, so it will not melt. Hope I am clear with this point. Okay. Then what is the second point? This carbon is very soft. Carbon is soft in comparison to copper. Copper is a hard material. If we compare copper and carbon, carbon is very soft. Okay? And your commutator is made up of copper, by the way. So when the commutator rotates, so there will be, already I have told, there will be friction between brush and commutator. Suppose this is your commutator. Okay, suppose this is your commutator and this is your brush. So when it will rotate, what will happen? This friction will happen with the brush. Okay, so since friction will happen, so it is going to, with the continuous movement of the commutator, so that there will be wear and tear in the commutator because of friction. For that reason, we are using carbon. Since it is very soft, so it will not damage the commutator. If it would have been a hard metal in place of carbon, then obviously commutator will get damaged due to friction. Hope I am clear with this point now. Okay. Now we will move to the third point. Third point is carbon is having negative temperature coefficient of resistance. What is negative temperature coefficient? coefficient of resistance. I think you have an idea. Negative temperature coefficient of resistance means if temperature increases, your resistance will decrease. Okay. Since heat is generated due to the spark, so temperature is bound to increase. So your temperature will increase. So when temperature will increase, your resistance will decrease. So what will happen? Low resistance. That means your current can flow easily because of this. Is it clear, children? Because of heat generated due to spark, temperature will increase. So resistance will decrease. For that reason, your current can flow easily. Hope it is clear now with the third point. See, it is not like that it will come in board examers. Since you are reading something, you should have the clarity why we are using this. So for that sake, I am explaining this. So this is your, you can say ki, that why, that hunger to know more. That, for that reason, I am explaining this, and obviously a separate class for this. Now what is your fourth reason? Come back. This carbon brush will easily take the shape of the commutator surface. How? Since already I have told carbon is soft, so it takes the shape of the commutator after some time. That means this is your commutator surface. If it is not carbon, it will be like this. If it is carbon, you can say, let me draw properly. So this is your commutator surface and this is your carbon thing. After some time, what will happen? Since it is soft and the brush na bristle, so it will take the shape of the commutator. Since carbon brush is soft, so it is very easy to take the shape of the commutator. So what will happen? That means more contact will be there. If more contact, that means maximum current flow will be there. Is it clear, children? Okay. Now comes to the fourth point. Sorry, this is a fourth, na? So we are discussing now last point, fifth point. This carbon is self-lubricating. That means no grease, no oil is required. You know friction, na? To reduce friction, this also I think you people know. To reduce the friction, suppose ball bearing in cycle, to reduce the friction, we'll add some grease, oil, so that friction will be less and no damage to your parts of the cycle and your cycle can run smoothly. Here in this case, carbon is self-lubricating. So that means no oil is required. How it is self-lubricating? Carbon is very soft and silky. Carbon is very soft and silky. Because of that, friction will be less. Is it clear, children? See how many advantages are there of this carbon brush. In like big motor also, we use graphite. So many compounds of carbon and graphite we use for different purpose of the motor. Big motor, different types of motor is there. Okay. Hope I am clear with this topic, why only carbon brush is used in motors. One more thing, can you people tell why we are using DC? Why this is a DC motor? Why we are not connecting with AC? DC you know, na, direct current. Direct current means your source is your battery over in this case, DC motor. Okay, children? And you know this armature coil will rotate. This thing you know. It will rotate. Suppose in case of DC, we will use AC. AC means alternating current. You will also read that in higher class. Okay. Even this 10th also, I will have I'll have the opportunity to tell about this alternating current and DC current. So, alternating current, our home supply is of alternating current only. This is of 220 volt 50 hertz supply. What is 50 hertz? What is 50 hertz? That is frequency. That means in every second the current will change its direction. This is a positive cycle, this is a negative half cycle. Okay? And this is a total one cycle. So every 50 hertz means in 1 second this current will change 50 times its direction. Positive, negative, positive, negative. See, the coil is rotating. Current is going like this, again it will change. In 1 second, 50 times it will change the direction. That means your armature coil will be like this. Like this. That means actually it will not move, it will be still. So we are not going to get a rotation of the parts. So motor will not function. That's why we are using DC. Hope I am clear with this also, why we are not using AC. Okay? So children, in my next lecture, we will be discussing electromagnetic induction, another, I think last part of our this chapter. It will take some lectures because very, very important, very important. Those who are pursuing also science after 10th, 12th, huge syllabus of this electromagnetic induction they are going to deal with. So in my next lecture, we are going to discuss electromagnetic induction. Hope you have enjoyed this lecture and hope in some way it is going to help you to enrich your knowledge. Okay? Study well. Stay safe. Take care of yourself, children. Thank you for watching.